in these two corners, black in these two corners. We do have that five-man pack.
If I was going to describe myself as a coach, I would say I'm an emotional coach. I'm a passionate coach.
Hold up here. Hold up. Hold up. Hold up. Hold up. It's the last drill we're doing. Finish the drill. Finish the drill.
I care an awful lot about our players. So here are some terms that I use frequently. Greasy goals.
So we've got to make that next step in order to get greasy goals.
We have a tendency to want to score pretty goals. The tic-tac-toe plays, the backdoor goals. Greasy goals are more a product of hard work, being around the net, a rebound, a tip. And it's something that we're trying to implement more and more because I think if we have that mentality, we'd be more productive offensively. North-South hockey, again, because we do have skill, I think we have a tendency to slow the play down a little bit. We want to go east-west. We don't get pucks and want to attack often enough through the neutral zone and attack the offensive zone. Weak side, strong side.
So everyone understand that? That thing gets wrapped on the weak side D. I see that thing wrapped. You're going to be on the strong side so that D can kick it back to you.
Weak side is when the puck is on the left side of the rink and you're trying to get it to the right side of the rink or you're trying to defend the right side of the rink. So it's the opposite side of the rink where the puck is at, and the strong side is where the side that the puck is actually at. And a lot of times in our sport, puck watching is a big problem. And the weak side is an area that can really be exposed if you're not if you're puck watching. Five-man pack. We do a good job coming back into our end. Phil may be a little bit more here, but at least he's not chasing. We do have that five-man pack. When the puck is stopped up, we want five guys around the puck in proper positions for a couple reasons. One, you want them around the puck to take away time and space to your opponent from a defensive perspective, plus you want to be structurally sound. And two, you want to put yourself in a position where if you do gain possession, you have somebody to pass it to. 50-50 area. On that neutral zone stuff, we'll drop a puck and we'll put it in a 50-50 area. Our sport is a sport that possession is constantly changing, so you're always trying to figure out how you're on offense or you're on defense. And there are a lot of times you're not sure if you're on offense and you're on defense because there's a question of possession. And we want to make sure that we're approaching it defensively when it's a 50-50 puck. High and fly. Smitty decides to high and fly because we do have some time. But I love, watch how he's always looking over his shoulder, right? He's looking. He knows this guy can't jump him. He stays in a good position because we've got spacing. So he highs and flies. When teams are really tight against us on a forecheck, when we get possession in our zone, one of the things we like to do is have one of our wingers high, a strong side winger, which is the side the puck's on. And then we like to fly our weak side winger when we have clear possession to free some space up for our defensemen in our center. Rhode Island humor.
Yeah, you didn't listen?
No, I did, but every line's doing something different.
So I'm gonna address right now. I don't wanna stop the drill.
I would say sarcasm is part of Rhode Island humor.